What's up, guys, and welcome to Myth Busting Mondays, episode 126. Yes, dudes, this is the show where we bust the myths that you guys leave in the comment section below. So if you guys have got any myths you would like to see featured in next week's episode, all you've got to do is leave those inside the comment section right now or at the end of the video, and we'll see which ones are featured next week. Those myths can range from World at War all the way through the Black Ops series, IW Zombies, World War II Zombies, and even Exo Zombies as well. Make sure the myths are super creative and ones that we've never done before, and you might just get featured in next week's episode. You guys have been absolutely smashing that like button on the videos recently and seriously supporting the channel. So if you want to continue that support, we're going to be aiming for 3,115 likes on this video. And also click that subscribe button right now if you guys are brand new to the channel to become the latest member of the Pizza Club. Our goal is 700,000 subscribers by the release of Black Ops 4 in October, and I know that you guys can do it, so please help us out. And with that said, let's jump into the first myth of today's show. So the first myth of today's show has been sent in by Jackson Ferry, and he says, myth, in Black Ops 1, because when you go down, you get to keep the ballistic knives when you are down, does that mean that you can then revive another down teammate while you're down? And loads of pizza emojis right there. So I'm going to jump over to Keto the Totem on Black Ops 1 with my boy Chopper, and also a random person because we had to go in a public lobby for this one, and let's go and see if we've got Pack-a-Punch ballistic knives. Can we revive another downed player while we're down? Let's check it out. Okay, guys. So here we are on the map, Keto the Totem. I'm with my boy Chopper and also a random person in this public lobby as well. And Chopper has the Pack-a-Punch ballistic knives right now as well. So Chopper's going to down himself. I'm going to down myself then as well. And then Chopper's going to shoot those ballistic knives at us. And then we're going to see if they will actually revive us while Chopper is down. Let's kill ourselves and let's check this out. Here we go. Chopper's going to be downing himself. There we go. And myself. Boom. Let's see. No, dude, Chopper's shooting us with the ballistic knife right now, and it is not doing anything. So the Pack-a-Punch ballistic knives that normally revive players while you are up do not work while you are down. And there's my boy right there, the random guy in the public lobby reviving both of us right there as well. But no, the ballistic knives cannot revive another down player while you are down inside of Black Ops 1 Zombies. Thank you so much to Jackson Ferry for sending that one in, and let's jump straight into the next myth of today's show right now, which is being sent in by Tim TBG. And Tim says, myth. On 5, is it possible to freeze the Pentagon Thief using the Winter's Howl / Winter's Fury? And 5 pizza emojis right there as well. Thank you, Tim. And you guys remember, if you are leaving myths, make sure you leave pizza emojis next to those myths as well. Because, you know, it makes me pretty hungry and they look cool as well. But let's jump over to the map 5. Let's get ourselves a Winter's Howl and let's see if we can freeze the Pentagon Thief on that map with that weapon. Let's jump over to 5 and let's check this out. Okay, guys, so we are on the map 5 right now and the Pentagon Thief round is about to begin. We've currently got the Ray Gun and we've also got the Winter's Howl. So as soon as this guy comes out of the teleporter, we're going to shoot him with the Ray Gun. Boom, there we go. And let's go and get him to take that Ray Gun off us and try and freeze him with the Winter's Howl. Here we go. Let's check this out. And no, dude, it looks like it's slowing him down, though. He's definitely going slower with that Winter's Howl. And there we go. We actually managed to kill him with the Winter's Howl as well. So it doesn't look like we can freeze the Pentagon Thief, but it definitely looked like he slowed down a lot, and it allowed us to actually kill the Pentagon Thief with that Winter's Howl as well. I never really used the Winter's Howl on 5 because I feel like it's a pretty inferior weapon, or definitely an inferior wonder weapon, but you know what? I might start using it a little bit more now, especially now that I know that it can actually kill the Pentagon Thief and slow the Pentagon Thief down as well. It's a pretty cool wonder weapon, very unique wonder weapon to 5, and I'm definitely going to use it a little bit more now. Tim, thank you so much for sending that myth, and that was really, really awesome. And let's jump straight onto the next myth of today's show right now, which is being sent in by the War Hunter 1234. And they say, myth, if you have a duplicated weapon, one Pack-a-Punch and one non-Pack-a-Punch, and you have no ammo for both, will you get ammo for the Pack-a-Punch weapon if you buy ammo for the un-Pack-a-Punch weapon? Now, this is a really cool idea. I don't think the amount of ammo that we've got inside of our clip will affect this, but we're going to jump over to the Eisendrack right now, and we're going to go and check out what happens if we've got duplicated weapons and we go up to the wall buy. Will it buy for the Pack-a-Punch one, or will it buy for the non-Pack-a-Punch one? Let's go and check this out. Okay, guys, so we're here on the Eisendrack. There's so many spots on DE as well where we can duplicate weapons, one at the HVK and also this one at the VMP as well. So we're going to do the VMP one today because the Pack-a-Punch machine is actually here. So let's place that inside of the Pack-a-Punch machine. Boop, there we go. And let's go make our way over to the wall buy again, buy another VMP, and then make our way straight back over to that Pack-a-Punch machine where we're going to receive our upgraded version as well. Okay, so there we go. We've got both variants of the VMP right now. We got ourselves the VMP Pack-a-Punch and also the non-Pack-a-Punch variant of that VMP. So all we've got to do now is go and kill a few zombies, lose a little bit of our ammo, and then go and hit the wall by. So I'm going to skip forward to when we actually do that. Okay, guys, so we've killed so many zombies. We've used quite a lot of ammo off both non-pack-a-punch and the pack-a-punch variant. But let's go and hit the wall by right now, and let's go and see exactly what happens when we buy that wall by. Is it going to give us the ammo for the non-pack-a-punch, or will it give us ammo for the pack-a-punch version? So we're going to run over to this right now with the non-pack-a-punch variant. So let's check this out. Boom, 4,500 points, which means it actually gave us ammo for the pack-a-punch variant of the weapon, even though we were holding out the non-pack-a-punch version. So this kind of sucks. I wish it gave us ammo for both weapons, but it doesn't. It just gives us 5,000 points worth of ammo for that pack-a-punch variant of the weapon. But there you go. Thank you so much to the War Hunter 1234 for sending that one in. You are an absolute legend, my dude. And let's jump straight over to the next myth of today's show right now, which has been sent in by FearX Scythe. And he says, myth, if you melt the ice to reveal a perk on the giant while using eye candy, will the laser's color change? And loads of pizza emojis right there as well. Thank you for sending that one in, Fear. So let's jump over to the giant where we're going to do the giant Easter egg. We're going to reveal that perk by melting all the ice by using the giant's laser. And we're going to drop the eye candy gobblegum while the laser is going off to see if the laser will change color. Let's jump over to the giant and let's check this out. Okay, guys, so here we are on the giant. This is currently my final teleporter that we've got to link up with the monkey bombs to actually access the secret perk Easter egg. So let's go through the teleporter right now. Let's get over to this area. Let's activate the laser. Here we go, and then we'll activate our eye candy, and no, dude. Well, kind of, but definitely not a lot. No, I'm gonna say no. It still remains orange. It went a little bit more vibrant, but I'm pretty sure that's what eye candy gobblegum does anyway. But it definitely didn't change color. It didn't go to green. It didn't go to blue. It just went to a little bit more of a vibrant version of that orange color. So I'm gonna say no. That didn't work, but it could have worked. But I appreciate FearX Scythe for sending that one in. Thank you so much, my dude. And let's jump straight over to the next myth of today's show right now, which has been sent in by the real Nexi. And they say, myth, if you put fireworks on the locust, does it still do a rapid fire shooting, even though the locust is bolt action? Now, this is something that I've clearly done in the past, but I really can't remember. And if we're going off logic here, it really shouldn't do a rapid fire if it's a bolt action sniper rifle, right? So let's jump over to Revelations today, where we're going to get the locust, and we're going to go and see if the locust is a rapid fire once fireworks goes off. Let's go check this out. Okay, guys, so here we are on Revelations. We've got fireworks on the locust right now as well, and all we're doing is killing zombies until it actually activates the specialist. So let's take all of these zombies onto the corruption engine right now. Surely one of them is going to activate that fireworks drop. And there it is. There it is. Rapid fire is on the locust during that fireworks drop. That's really, really cool. So I kind of think this would have been awesome if they would have actually allowed something along the lines of rapid fire on the locust in general that you could actually use. That would have been really cool, but unfortunately not. Unfortunately, you can only access it on fireworks, but still, it looks awesome. So there you go. Yeah, rapid fire does activate on fireworks if you have it on the locust, which is a bolt action sniper rifle. Okay, guys, so we're going to be jumping over to that awesome segment that you guys love on this show right now, which is called Throwback Myth of the Week, where we show you guys a myth from a previous episode of Myth Busting Mondays, and this week is one of my favorites. The reason why this is one of my favorites is because this is now being patched. This was such a cool thing to do while you were playing Der Eisendrak, and that was to get one of your friends to use Killing Time while you were using the Wonder Sphere. You would get stuck in midair and you could spin around and check out the whole of the map. You can even complete the Firebow quest while you were in the air by shooting those golden circles on the ground. It actually made it really easy to do that Firebow quest, and I used to do it all the time. But unfortunately, this got patched pretty soon after this video went pretty viral, and unfortunately, we don't have it anymore. But you know what? We've still got the memories, we've still got the video, and that was basically freezing ourselves on the Wonder Sphere on Der Eisendrak. But there you go. That was our throwback myth of the week for this week on Mythbusting Mondays, episode 26, and let's jump straight in to our final myth of today's show right now, which has been sent in by Extreme Gamer 458, and they say, myth, what happens on Mob of the Dead if Weasel leaves during the boss fight? Also, can I get a shout out on my YouTube channel, please? Extreme Gamer 458, you can get a shout out, my friend, but I'm more interested in the Mob of the Dead myth that you left. I've never even thought about this, and I don't think anyone's really tried this, mainly because who would leave on the boss fight of Mob of the Dead? They want to see the ending, right? They want to do the fight inside of the boss fight. But I know one guy that will do this for us, and that's my boy Chopper. If you guys haven't already subscribed to him, go and check him out. His link will be inside the description right now. But Chopper's going to jump onto Mob of the Dead with us. We are going to play all the way through the Easter egg, and then once we get to the end, Chopper's going to leave when we've got that symbol above our head telling us that we are into the boss battle. And then we'll see exactly what happens when someone leaves in the boss fight on Mob of the Dead. But let's check this out. Here we go. Okay, guys, so here we are. Me and Chopper are on the final step of Mob of the Dead right now, where we are on the Golden Gate Bridge. We just need to revive ourselves, and as soon as we do that, we are going to get Brutuses spawned into the map. We're going to instantly kill those Brutuses to make it a little bit easier for ourselves. We're going to look at each other as soon as Chopper gets that symbol above his head, and we're then going to see what happens when he leaves the game. So there you go. The final Brutus has just died. Chopper's got that symbol above his head. Let's stare at Chopper and Chopper leave the game in 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, dude, there we go. Chopper left the game. The cycle continues. There we go. So, yes, the Easter egg will still finish if the person leaves the game who is Weasel. The cycle continues, my dudes. So there we go. That must have been one of the only times ever someone has gone on this screen of one player completing Mob of the Dead. Absolutely insane. But there you go. That has been Mythbusting Mondays episode 126. If you guys have enjoyed the episode at all, make sure you absolutely smash the like button on this video right now. We'll aim for 3,115 likes. And if you guys are brand new to the channel, make sure you click that subscribe button to become the latest member of the Pizza Club. We're going to be aiming for 700,000 subscribers by the release of Black Ops 4 in October. So help support the channel by leaving that like or leaving that subscription. And I'll see you guys in the next video or the next live stream. Thank you so much for watching and peace out.